So we're here today with Marty Knollenberg, who is running for re-election for state senate in the 13th district. How are you today?
I'm doing awesome. It's great to be on our legislative break so we can spend time in the community connecting with the constituents.
Well, thank you for coming. Can you tell me what communities are in the 13th district?
It's a great district. We've got great people living there, 5 downtowns, 8 cities. They include Rochester, Rochester Hills, Troy, Clawson, Royal Oak, Berkeley, Birmingham, and the city of Bloomfield Hills.
Now, you are state senator. Can you tell us a little bit about your political background beyond that?
Yeah, so I've been a business owner for most of my career and started my political career back in 2002. And I was asked to run for county commissioner. And so I did that for 2 years. I ran for state rep. I was a state rep for 6 years. And so I'm running for re-election for state senate.
Now, what are some of the things that you've been able to accomplish in the Senate so far?
We've gotten really a lot done in the legislature as a state senator. Obviously, the infrastructure issue is a huge issue. My constituents are always asking, what are we doing about the roads and the infrastructure? And so several years ago, the legislature did pass legislation that will help to more fund our roads and infrastructure systems. So that's a big thing, and obviously have more to do, but it's a good start. Education is also a big, big issue. And, for me, it's a passion of mine, and, every child should have the opportunity to be able to have the education that they deserve. And then, thirdly, just I believe in local control, and I've been able to secure a saving to a local community of over $20 million to their local road system. Essentially, the state of Michigan, MDOT, wanted our local communities to pay for the I-75 road project, and it's really a state-owned road and not a local road. And so there's some matching requirements that our local units had to pay for. So I was able to eliminate the matching requirement, thus forcing the state of Michigan to pay for a road that they own and saving our local communities a lot of money, $20 million, so they can put into their own road systems.
Now, you are unopposed in the primary, but you will be facing a Democrat in November. Why should people vote for you?
You know, I've been, I grew up in Michigan. I've been a product of Oakland County for almost 53 years. And I'm local. And I went to public schools here. I've owned and operated businesses here. I've been involved in community organizations here in the community. And I own a local restaurant. And every month we do a stakeout for charity day. And we are flat iron steaks at normally $17. We dropped the price down to $7. And so a dollar of that goes to a local charity. Every month the charity changes, but the $7 deal remains. And so I've been a part of this community for, a really long time, my entire life pretty much. And so I think I'm connected with the community. And I think that's what we need, somebody that understands the ups and downs of what we have seen, in Michigan.
Now, if people want more information about you and your campaign, where do they go?
It's very easy, MartyKnollenberg.com. We're on Facebook. We have a Twitter account, and I have a voting record, too.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
You're welcome. Thank you.